I went to sing this song a while back, and I was thinking, as I started to sing, I thought, oh, it's gender specific, I need to clean that up. And then, as I got into it, I suddenly realized, no, this is about the lives of men. I don't need to fix a thing. So what I'd like to do, if you'll let me, is let's sing a line, and then let me talk about it a little, and then we'll sing another line. How many roads must a man walk down before they call him a man? I think that's the crux of it right then. At what point in his life has any man ever proved once and for all that he's a real man, right? Why do we do that? How many seas must a white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? Over-responsibility, overburdening is a part of every man's life. And rest? Sitting in front of the TV with a beer doesn't actually look like rest. How many times must a cannonball fly before they're forever banned? Little boys play at war not because of some, you know, gender-based testosterone poisoning. Children play what they're trying to figure out. That's what they do. When my boys were small, I tried to say, no guns. My grandsons, I get down on the floor, and I die as many times as they need me to, as dramatically as I can figure out. And I'm trying to be in there with them and help them figure it out, because I don't have it figured out, but maybe if we try to figure it out together, we'll get there. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. How many years must a mountain exist before it's washed to the sea? Endurance of men just amazes me. I've seen men kill themselves just pushing day after day, just in the hopes that somebody somewhere someday might get some use out of it. There's also a sense of the deep anger of men. You want to see an angry man? Look at an 11-year-old boy. They're starting to get a picture of what they're facing. And we all get scared of that. We get scared of the heat under the volcano, and we try to bury it really deep. But there's a lot of power there that could be used to work for a lot of good. And how many years can some people exist before they're There have been men at the forefront of everybody's liberation struggle all the time. It's about time we put men out front in some ways. How many times can a man turn his head and pretend he just doesn't see? When I was in the 60s, I thought that man was a jerk. But looking back on it, the way that men are forced to not notice what's been done to them, what's being done to them, of course they can't see what's happening to somebody else, you know. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is spite of the way that their own personal lives go, is very moving to me. How many ears must one man have before he can hear people cry? The ears of every person on the planet listening to individual men about what their lives were like. And it gets twisty here because it's so easy for it to become one more role that men are supposed to play well, you know, the sensitive new age guy. We're going to have to figure out a way to listen so it's safe enough for men to talk about figuring out how to avoid or survive getting beaten up as middle-sized boys by older boys day after week after month after year in their young lives. And for most men, safety and closeness are polar opposites. So we've got some work to do here, you know. And how many deaths will it take till he knows? Too many people have died. The men in charge of the military in every country in the world are men who have been through combat themselves without any chance to heal afterwards. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Sing it with me. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The